At first, welcome to all of you and thanks for coming today. Today, inshallah, we have two topics. The first one about how to prepare for MRSOG part 2 exam. I know that many of you are preparing for the next exam, which will be in February 2020. And the second session, inshallah, will be a scientific one. We will talk today about phenylketonuria with pregnancy, which is an important talk article, and it's very important, so we need to discuss it today. The first topic, how to prepare for the exam. You will ask me, Dr. Osama, is it sufficient time from now to prepare for February exam? The good news, yes, it's sufficient. Okay, we are now on July. We have July, August, October, November, December, and January. So you have full 6 months. It's a very good time to start. If you didn't start yet, you have to start now. And there's a good news that always time available for February candidates is longer than the time available for July candidates. So enjoy this time. You have to start now studying for the exam. You need hard studying from now. It will be more and more serious and hard studying in the last 3 months before the exam. Today, I will tell you how to prepare the best for the exam in this available time. At first, let's have an idea about the exam. Some of us didn't join the exam yet and they are applying for part 2 exam for the first time. Okay, our part 2 exam is based upon, we have two papers, first paper and second paper. Each paper of them is containing 50 single best answer and 50 EMQ. Okay, this is the exam format. Two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Each one of them is having single best answer, 50 single best answer, and 50 extended matching questions. So paper 1, and there is a break, then paper 2, each paper of them 3 hours. Each paper containing 50 single best answer and 50 EMQ. You notice it's a long time. 6 hours of solving questions. 6 hours. It should be full concentration in these 6 hours. You remember in part one, it was two papers also, but each paper 2 hours and a half. Part two exam is longer than this. So you have to be trained how to tolerate 6 hours of solving questions, 6 hours of full concentration. You have to be trained of this. You have to be trained to do this. To be frank, some doctors find passing the exam difficult, not because of the difficulty of questions. Sometimes because of this long time, it's exhausting for all of us. So one of my benefits and one of my targets in the exam to train you how to tolerate this long time, these 6 hours. You have to be full concentration in these 6 hours so as not to miss any question. Okay, and throughout all the course, you are trained how to prepare and how to solve single best answer and how to solve EMQs. Alhamdulillah, the feedback from our friends in the last exam July, this July, that all the exam came from the course. Even if you didn't take the course, I will tell you from where you can get the source of studying for the exam. So when will be the next exam? It will be in February, inshallah, February 2020. It will be Tuesday. You know that always part one have their exam in Monday and part two, they have their exam on Tuesday. So it will be Tuesday, 4th of February. So you have a good time, trust me. It's a very good time if you start studying from now. The first step to prepare for Part 2 exam is to prepare your assessment of training, or we call it a training assessment. How to do it? It's an application. Okay, you will download it from the RSOG website. You will fill this form, which containing data about how you were trained in the last 4 years. Okay, because it's important and needed to be able to book for the exam. The good news, the time for online application for the assessment of training didn't start yet. But you have to prepare it from these days. Nowadays, you have to prepare it. When it opens, you will start application online so they can give you a reply that you have the right now to access and to book for the next Part 2 exam. Booking for the exam will start on August. So after 1 month, inshallah. And it will continue for further 1 month. It will close on October. So prepare your assessment of training now. So you will send it when the assessment of training starts. Then you will have the right to book for the exam, inshallah. So start from now, preparing your assessment of training. How much fees for the exam? They divide the countries into 4 groups, UK and Ireland, Group A, Group B, Group C. Egypt is Group B. And each group has specific exam fees. They classify it according to how countries can tolerate exam fees. Okay, Egypt is in band B. So if you will book from Egypt, you will pay 427 sterling pounds. Okay, the venues. We have venues for the exam in UK and overseas. Overseas, Egypt is present, Hong Kong. Okay, of course, there is in Saudi Arabia. Okay, in Riyadh, in Singapore, Emirates, in India. And unfortunately, the center of Sudan is cancelled nowadays because of the circumstances in Sudan. Allah be with them. I think most of us will have the exam. Most of you will have the exam in Egypt or in Saudi Arabia, in India, in Pakistan, and in Saudi Arabia. This is the exam format. Okay, so without courses, how can I prepare for the exam? So I will tell you from where you can get the references and sources for the exam. One of the important sources is NICE guidelines. So you have to study very well the NICE guidelines related to gynecology and obstetrics. From this NICE website, you can obtain, if you press here, NICE guidance, view guidance, you can download for free. Here the guidelines related to gynecology and obstetrics. And you will find that it's always updated. Always updated. The last NICE guideline related to our exam was the preeclampsia guideline. It was published June 2019, last month. Hypertension in pregnancy. So you will download it. It's important. And all guidelines related to gynecology and obstetrics, you will download it and study them. Okay, the second source, which is actually more important than the NICE guideline, is the green top guidelines. From the RSOG website, you can access all these guidelines and download them. Here are they. Okay, you can order them, whatever. I like ordering them by date, from the most recent to the oldest. You will find that the last published guideline, also it was the last month. It's about preterm labor. So you will use it instead of the nice guideline about preterm delivery. So you can download all these guidelines. Okay, then you press page 2, page 3, you will download all of them. The next source, the TOG articles. Also, you can access them from the ArtsOG website. You can access the TOG articles and you can study them. From here, you can study the TOG articles. Are they important? Yes, very important. When you hear about the previous exams and you hear about that there were difficult questions, we don't know from where these difficult questions came. They came from TOG articles. So studying TOG articles is important. But unfortunately, we have hundreds of TOG articles. Usually we concentrate on the TOG articles published within the last 3 or 4 years, but there are very, very important TOG articles from previous years, from 2010, 2011. Doctor, they are 8 or 9 years older. Yes, they are important. So at least start by the last, by the latest 3 or 4 years, and then return to the most important old ones. Another source, from Faculty of Sexual and Reproductive Health. From here, you can download the guidelines about contraception. Okay, from here, guidance, current guidance. You will download the guideline about combined contraception, about emergency contraception, long-acting contraception. Download all the guidelines. The next one, for HIV. And for infections. For infections, you will download from the BASH website. Okay, from here. You will download all the guidelines related to infection, about chlamydia, about BID. From here, guidelines and standards. You will download all the important guidelines. From here, current guidelines. Okay, all guidelines. Gonorrhea, chlamydia, mycoplasma, vaginal discharge. Download all of them. Herpes, very important. BID. And for HIV, we'll download the guideline from the Behiva website. Okay, from here you will download the last guidelines about HIV with pregnancy. Very important. So these are the most important sources for studying and preparing for the exam. Okay, also, there are some sources like from the GMSC website. You can download guidelines about governance and about ethics. And also, you need to read some parts from the UK law, like about Fraser Guideline, about Child Protection Act. You need to study them also. They are important and they come in the exam. So, without courses, this will be the sources of data needed for the exam. Actually, I don't like reading textbooks. Why? As you see, all those guidelines are updated. There is no textbook on earth which included the guidelines published the last month. And each month you will find new guidelines and again updates and again updates. From where you can get this? You can't get this from textbook. Okay, let's say that the textbook is updated. It will be published 2018, or at the first month of 2019, it missed the newest guidelines. So I don't like actually textbooks for reading for the exam, because maybe you are reading an old data and this exam will ask about the recent data. Okay, what happened in the previous courses? Okay, if you had your assessment of training before, you don't need to prepare a new one. No need to repeat the assessment of training. Once done, finished, you can book the exam as long as it was accepted. Okay, Dr. Heber, no need to do another assessment of training. Okay. What happened in the previous courses? Okay, alhamdulillah, always the success rate for the course is around 80%. Okay, I will go quickly through the congratulations and the honor list from previous courses. Okay, all these candidates passed. This was in the course preparing for July 2017. And all these candidates passed in January 2018 exam. All these passed from these different countries in July 2018. And always success rate around 80%, alhamdulillah. And all these passed in January 2019. And inshallah, waiting for the list. This also from January 2019. Okay, I had consent from these doctors, of course. Some of them are preparing for part three now. Some of them already passed the part three. Some of them already giving courses for part three. Okay, and best wishes, and I pray for doctors who joined the exam in July 2019, wishing for them the best. I am waiting eagerly for 6th of August. This is the day in which the result will be published, inshallah. So waiting for the result. Inshallah, it will be fine. And inshallah, we will be happy by celebrating with them their success. Okay, but this was apart from their feedback after having the exam in July. Alhamdulillah, exam was all from the course, no new thing. If you study well, inshallah, you will pass. Okay, pick the important hints. Okay, you can answer from the notes. It was easy, alhamdulillah. Nothing out of the course and out of the revision. It will be easy for who studied the course. Okay, and this is from the reply on the Facebook after the exam. Okay, it helped a lot. Okay, and it was easy explanation for the guidelines. So alhamdulillah, it was good feedback from my brothers and sisters from previous course. Okay, and even some doctors studied from, there is all the material for me from 2017. Some doctors even read from it, although it's an old one, it's from 2017. Some read from it and alhamdulillah, they solve it well in the exam without having the course. But it's an old one. Okay, I always update my lectures. Each day, before each lecture, I update it. I confirm that it's updated. Okay, the new course preparing for February 2020 exam, how it will be? The exam is combo. The course is prepared on three steps. The first one, long course. Then step two, the condensed revision. Then step three, the mock exams. Okay, it's composed of three steps. Number one, the long course. Number two, the condensed revision course. Number three, the mock exams. Okay, usually we finish these steps about 1 week before the exam. So I will be with you until 1 week before the exam. Long course, It's composed of 38 scientific days. And there is a timetable for this. It's each Tuesday and Friday. Tuesday and Friday. We meet online like today. And actually even the same time like today, 10 a.m. Cairo time, 9 a.m. UK time, I start on Friday. 38 scientific days, each Tuesday and Monday. We stay together about 4 to 5 hours each day of them. Okay, I give the lecture, I explain the PowerPoint, which summarizes. For example, the PowerPoint about contraception. It's prepared from dozen of guidelines about contraception and the sum of the top articles and the sum of other evidences like scientific impact paper, like consent advices. So the lecture is topic wise and the sources of the lecture is multiple sources. 38 scientific days each Tuesday and Friday. After finishing the lecture, okay, I upload to our private website, I upload the PowerPoint and I upload the video. So you can study from it until February exam. After February exam, the drive and the site expires. So you don't need to study from any other evidence. Dr. Osama, do I need to read the guidelines? No. Do I need to read any other evidence? No, just read the presentations. It's more than enough. More than enough, alhamdulillah. Okay, the long course ends or it will end at 1 January. So we can start the condensed revision, which is composed of 5 scientific days. In this condensed revision course, I concentrate upon the most important points in most of the topics from the long course. And I also add some data in the condensed revision course. So you can remember well them. You can remember them well in the exam. Each day of the days of the condensed revision course, we stay together about 10 to 12 hours. So I am talking about 50 to 60 hours crash course. Very hardworking, but I am sure, like what happened in each previous course, you will enjoy it. You will not fall asleep. You will enjoy it. And already you have an exam after 3 or 2 weeks. Already you are concentrating. You will not fall asleep. And you will gain much information. I will summarize the curriculum in this condensed revision course. So, when you hear the information on the long course and you hear it again in the condensed course, you memorize it by heart. In the last 1 or 2 weeks before the exam, we started discussing mock exams. I send to you 2 mock exams. You solve them at home in the same condition like the exam with the real exam. Each paper has 50 single best answer and the 50 MQ. In the mock exam, you will solve 70 single best answer, 70 MQ, and in less than 3 hours. So you can be trained well how to do time management in the exam. After you solve them, you send me your answer sheet. And then we meet online to solve these mock exams together. So we can discuss to see where is the defect. So these are the 3 steps. This is the advertisement about the meeting today. Okay, these are the timing of the meetings of the long course. Friday and Tuesday. In each day of them, we study 1 or 2, sometimes 3 small topics. Okay, this is the timing, 10 a.m. Cairo time, and the Tuesday, 2 p.m. Cairo time, we stay about 4 or 5 hours in each day of them. Okay, this is a list of not all, but most of the topics which are studied in the long course. Teaching, early pregnancy, diabetes, DKA, systemic lupus, ectopic collapse, hypertension, small for gestational age, recurrent pregnancy loss, thrombocytopenia, preterm labor, cesarean section, labor care, VTE, venous thromboembolism, twins, breech, asthma, anti-RBCs, antibodies, thalassemia, sickle cell disease, breast cancer, psychiatric disease, cardiac disease with pregnancy, neurological disease with pregnancy, nerve injury, gynecology and obstetrics, induction of labor, group B, streptococci, headache, surgical incisions, reduced fetal kicks, twins, skin eruptions with pregnancy, postpartum hemorrhage, some important talks, renal diseases with pregnancy, IOFD, governance, amniocentesis, morbidly adherent placenta, antepartum hemorrhage, contraception, infertility, urogynecology, laparoscopy, hysteroscopy, ovarian cyst, non-menopause and post-menopause, HRT, sexual assault, heavy menstrual bleeding, complex social factors, endometrial cancer, obesity, osteoporosis, National Health Society cervical screening program, cancer cervix, pelvic organ prolapse, female genital mutilation, hirsutism, premenstrual tension syndrome, and postmenopausal symptoms, statistics, infections, vulval disease, sepsis in during pregnancy and postpartum sepsis, ergonomics in laparoscopy, ovarian cancer, thyroid disease, antenatal care, endometriosis, irritable bowel disease, endometrial hyperplasia, systemic lupus, inflammatory bowel disease, phenylketonuria, and more others. And I add more topics. Okay, and these are some of the topics which discussed in the condensed revision. Okay, again, these are the three steps of the course, the longer course, followed by the crash course, followed by the mock exam. You don't need any other source to study. You don't need to read the guideline. Get your mind out of the guidelines. They are summarized in the PowerPoint. So what can take from you 12 hours, it will take 4 or 5 hours in the PowerPoint. You have the summary. And this is a screenshot from the drive, which has the 38 scientific days. Okay, in each folder of them, you will find the PowerPoint. So you can study online until February exam. And also you will find the video. It's recorded. Okay, here inside the folder, you will find the PowerPoint and the video. Okay, thank you. And I am ready to accept questions. Please, if you want to ask, you can open your mic now if you want. Okay, about the fees, I can't tell in private because we are now on Facebook Live now. You can ask if you want, you can open your mic if you want. Okay, any questions about the course, about the preparation, about how to study, about the exam?
Hello.
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 Actually, I want to ask if we are busy at the time of the online lecture, then can we hear the lecture later?
Sure. The data is available online anytime, 24 hours per day, until February exam. And as I told you, this will be your source of studying. So it's available until the exam.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, Dr. Muhammad.
Please, Dr. Sam, how about solving recalls?
Okay, I don't want to say recalls. Okay, if you say recalls, you can be banned from the UK, from the RSOG. Okay, but let's say the word important questions. After each topic, we study and we solve together the important questions about the topic. So it's integral part. And today we will study phenylketonuria. And after studying phenylketonuria, we will solve the questions about BKU. So solving the questions is an integral part of the course. Okay, we will solve hundreds of questions. How? Topic-wise. After each lecture, we solve the questions. related to it together in the meeting.
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Osama.
Wa alaikum salam, Dr. Khaleda. Hello.
Actually, I appeared in July exam, but I'm not yet sure whether I will pass or I will not pass. But if I want to join you after the result, and if I unluckily could not success, then can I join the course after the result? It's okay.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. And inshallah, I wish you pass, inshallah.
Your prayers. The paper was not difficult.
Yes.
BA portion was really very straightforward, but this time they gave in our paper, EMQs were all from the labor patients, yani preterm labor, breech presentation, APH, and that make us yani a little more, so many patients for the labor, so many questions from the laboring patient. So that's why we are not yet sure that whether we will pass, and EMQs are really, we don't know how to. SBS, we are 100% sure we will pass, but EMQs, we don't know. So I hope so we will pass. If not, then I'm thinking to join you. So can I join later part? Because after
yes,
I will
yes,
think
course.
After about
it. Of course. And actually, I was intending to start the course earlier than this, but I tried to delay the course, so we will start 19th
of July. So
yes.
Yeah, it will be less than, you know, this we have less time actually for the July exam. It was really less time, especially we started
sure.
in February. It and now these people, those who are, I hope so we will pass if we could not pass, but those who are appearing in February, really good time for them.
You are right. Okay, and here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and the best wishes for you. I wish you pass, inshallah. Okay, you find here these red rectangles or squares around the timing of the meetings. You will find all are Fridays and Tuesdays. Okay, these are 39. Actually, I give 38, but I add one extra because sometimes I add new topics from different sources. So these are 39 lectures, as you see. Okay, each Tuesday, this one should be moved to Friday. Okay, Tuesdays and Fridays, also here, Friday. Okay, so these are 39 lectures, and these are the timings of the crash course, Tuesday and Friday. Okay, we have 5 scientific days, each one about 10 to 12 hours. Okay, and this is a brochure about the new course. Yes, other questions?
Dr. Osama.
Yes, Dr. Hussain. Hello, how are you?
How are you? Alhamdulillah. As for those who attended the course before and unfortunately not pass the exam, do you recommend to follow the same course sequentially, or they can study and at the same time attend the lecture, study by their own, yani solving, because they have a good background? Will you start from the start with you? What do you recommend?
Okay, look, as I told you, the material is always changing. The material which was used in the previous 6 months will not be 100% valid for the next 6 months. That's why for candidates who unfortunately they don't pass the exam, I give them discount 50% so they can attend the next one.
Hello?
Okay. So can you give us your feedback about the previous course? Dr. Hussain attended the previous course.
Boss, I attended the previous course and I attended all lectures online, but unfortunately I had no time to revise them probably. So I recommend each one who will inshallah attend the course to study it well.
Sure.
Yani if he studied from the start, it will, at the end of the course, he will not need extra time for revision, and he will be probably prepared. And there will be the time left for revision, because the only mistake I did, I had no time for proper revision. But the exams, all the materials, if you concentrate and focus on the course material, you don't need anything else, differently. So I recommend everyone, after finishing the lecture, there is a good time and enough time in between the two lectures or the three lectures per week to listen to it again and again, because at the end of the course, the time left, it's enough only for solving question. And from my own experience, don't rely on the recalls, because as we saw in this exam, about less than 10% of questions came from the recalls. So our focus were on the recalls, and that's not very really good. So I recommend everyone to attend the course and listen to the lecture more than once, because if he leaves them to the end of the course, there may be no time for revision. Okay? Second case, try to solve questions online, like in addition to the question we are solving already in the course, like strategy will ask OG questions, because at the end of the course we had no time to solve it. This is my advice for all. Don't search for extra sources, just depend on the course material, and you can solve the extra three or four recent books from 2017 to 2018, 2019 only. And this is my advice. And I will, inshallah, if unfortunately not the best course, follow the lectures, isn't it good? In addition, I will serve by all, because I have good background from the last course. And inshallah, bittawfiq, with my best wishes for all.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for sharing your experience. Yes, of course, as long as you are intending to join the next exam and already you started a course, study. Study with the course, be strict with the course. Take the lecture today, study it in the same day or the next day. So you are regular with it. Don't miss anything. Okay, actually, in relation to strategy,
Dr. Osama, there is something else I want to say. One of the difficulties I face last time is the incidents and the figures. But at the end of the course, I felt that many figures came frequently. If colleagues stuck to the course and studied from the start, at the end of the course, they will not feel anything unpopular. Most of the figures, the most common, will be engraved in their mind. So I recommend them from the start to listen to the lecture online. I feel unfortunately they attend to listen it one or two times before the next lecture. At the end of the lecture, most of the incidents will be repeated more than one times. This is one of the difficulties I faced, because I didn't revise well the course material.
Excellent. And we are through the course always, I am trying to repeat numbers. For example, even in the lecture today about BQU, when we find the prevalence of BQU and what is the number of cases, I will connect between these numbers and I will ask in which topics these numbers were repeated. So I always try to remind and refresh your mind about the numbers. So don't think that numbers are a difficulty. No, it's not difficult. It's always repeated, and repeated, you will memorize it by heart from repeating. So it's not a problem, inshallah. And in addition to this, I will give, and even I put it on Facebook as free for every doctor, a PDF about the important numbers in the curriculum. I will send it to all of you. I bought it on Facebook for free for everybody. Other questions? Thanks a lot, Dr. Hussam. Other questions?
Dr. Hussam.
Yes.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام دكتور نادية.
من فضلك دكتور, if I attended this course, that means it will be the first online course I attended. I mean, I didn't have experience about how to follow or how to enjoy online course. But inshallah, with the helping, I will be join this course. This is number one. Number two, I would like to ask regarding the strategies of the attended. I mean, there will be everyday lectures, for example, like a timetable. For example, today we'll join lecture about tafta, and so on, in order to help in the following of the course, to be step by step, until at the end of the course, I will find myself, I will cover all or most of the lectures smoothly, without jumping or without like these things. I mean, it's like we are in the strict timetable and follow the lectures. It would be like this.
Very good question. Look, we have fixed time for the meetings. Okay, as I told you, we have twice meetings per week on Tuesday and Friday. And according to this timetable, you will know the timing of the meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Here, each Tuesday and Friday. So we have fixed time for the lectures. In addition to this, we are present on the WhatsApp group. The course has a WhatsApp group, so we can talk when we need. We can discuss some questions also throughout the week. Okay, and even it's not one-man show. One of the useful things in the course is that we are a group. So you do copy and paste from the data from your friends to your brain. It's another benefit from being one group. So you will help each other. It's another benefit from the course. And I think that the friendship which comes from this situation will never vanish. It will persist for life. You will be friends for life.
Yeah, and that means the lectures will be already on the course. A material of the course will be inside the group. I mean, at any time, if I would like to show the lectures,
yes,
or you, I can at any time in the night, in the morning, because my life is busy a little bit.
You are right.
And I would, yes, I didn't have strict. For example, today maybe I can read or I can show the lectures in the evening, tomorrow maybe in the morning, and so on. I mean, it will be flexibility on the time showing or what?
Look, the material of today is a PowerPoint and the video will be uploaded to the site. Let's say that after 1 week you want to study the lecture. Okay, open the drive, open the video, study. No problem at all.
I will have a username and password.
Sure, you will have private access until February exam. As I told you, one of the very important benefits of the course, and even I put it by very big font, as you see, you don't need to study from any other source. You will study from the course material. Don't buy textbooks. Don't download guidelines. You will find everything, inshallah, in the PowerPoint. You can study any time until the exam.
I had attended for previously, but unfortunately I didn't pass because I didn't prepare it very well. This is the main reason why I attended this course. I would like to be in group, in one good guidance me, how to read, how to prepare, what is the most important I have to concentrate it, how to, the tips and the trick. This is the main aims from the attended of the course.
Mm-hmm. Look, one of the difficult things in part two, that there is endless source of knowledge. How can we cope with this? Endless source of evidence, very, very large source of evidence. If you download everything, you will find that your laptop is full of lectures, full of guidelines, uh-huh, and you can do nothing with this.
That's true.
That's
and the
why
other thing,
only study the PowerPoint. You have 38 excellent scientific days, study them well. Then the crash course, which will repeat the important data in the longer course and will add some extra points, and then study the mock exams. And alhamdulillah, our friends said that many of the questions of the mock exam came in July exam.
Excellent. The other thing I heard from you when you are beginning, it's regarding the time, how to cooperate it with the time of the exam. That's true. In the part two paper, I found it's my brain so tired to concentrate, and I want just to leave the exam. I mean, it's so, so important, especially for someone who will enroll the exam the first time. That's true regarding how to cooperate yourself to the time of the exam. It's so, so important. And thank you so much.
Do you imagine that Dr. Nadia can tolerate an online meeting for 12 hours? Do you imagine this? You
will do this. It's hard.
You will do this. When you do this, you will find that 6 hours of the exam is not difficult. I had an online meeting. I was concentrating for 12 hours, 5 times in the months before the exam. So you will find that,
that
6 hours is not a dilemma. You know, even in the last course, and Dr. Hussain is available with us, the first day of the crash revision course, the lecture was 13 hours. Do you imagine this? 13 hours. You'll find that 6 hours of the exam is not difficult. I had a meeting for 13 hours and I was concentrating.
But Dr. Osama, Dr. Osama.
Yes, in brief, Dr. Osama. In brief, Dr. Hussain, please. Yes.
But something not mentioned clearly. I want to reassure all colleagues who are intending to attend this course. There is greatest benefit of attending this course, which is not available any place else. Any, you will not find a tutor or helpful a teacher. You find him with you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's not only attend the days of the lecture twice or thrice a week. You will find a WhatsApp where our colleagues are sharing their queries, questions, difficulties, and in case of you meet something difficult, you can communicate with Dr. Osama through his own WhatsApp line or through the group line and explain. If you have no time to search for a talk article for a difficult question, he can help. So that you don't imagine who with you, a faithful tutor, well, 24 hours a day, seven days a week, from now until the day of the exam. This is not available in any course. I listened to many of my colleagues who attended other courses. They told me that you are fortunate. We may see the lecturer or the tutor only on the lecture. You don't imagine. Dr. Osama was with me when I went to the exam room only 3 hours earlier before the exam started. He was with me and encouraging me and solve calmly. This is the greatest benefit, truly and honestly.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Hussain. Okay, and I am always present on WhatsApp. If there is any difficult point in the lecture, I can explain. If there is a question, I can tell you what can be the key for this question.
And is the Dr. Osama, they may don't know that benefit. Yeah, and I want to just to clearly mention it.
Thanks a lot. Thank you. Okay, other questions? Other questions? Okay.
Excuse me, Dr. Osama. Sorry.
Yes, Dr. Nadia, here you are.
I would like just to regarding the information regarding the course and how to enjoy, to join it. I can send to you by the Facebook or by the messengers, the information or by the WhatsApp group.
Okay, the best way and the easiest way to communicate with me is on my WhatsApp number. This is it.
Okay.
002-0100-806-7383. This is the best way to communicate with me because I don't access to Facebook frequently. Okay, but WhatsApp and even Telegram, I don't like Telegram very much, but this WhatsApp is the best way to communicate with me. Okay, please write it.
Uh-huh. And if I have any other questions or any something in my mind,
on the group, yes.
Would you put the WhatsApp and you will guide
yes,
me?
Yes. I add the course members to a group so they can study together. If there is difficult question, it will be put on the group so I can explain it by voice message or by a writing paper, and I put it on the group so it will be easy for all.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And best wishes for you. Thank you. Okay, other questions?
Dr. Usama, thank you for excellent presentation. How are you, Dr. Usama?
Thank you. Welcome very much.
Thank you for excellent presentation. And you are the best instructor for RCOG. The third time I attend for your course, because you are updating. And I wish I pass.
Inshallah.
The exam can... يعني إن شاء الله يعني كان بجد يعني دكتور أسامة famous all questions from the crash course only يعني you are very يعني excellent دكتور أسامة excellent فعلا يعني حضرتك ما شاء الله ما شاء
Thank
الله
you. دكتور best أسامة. wishes for you my friend إن شاء الله
يا رب يا دكتور إن شاء الله for all my colleague إن شاء الله يا دكتور
إن شاء الله best wishes for you thanks a lot
thanks يا دكتور thank you
Thank you. Okay, other questions? Okay. Thank you very much. We finished now the first session. And now we will... Yes, Dr. Muhammad. Yes.
Sorry, could you ask, it's possible to study from hard copy?
In private. In private.
I have to download
yes, the PowerPoint. Send it to me on WhatsApp. Send this question on WhatsApp. Okay. I throw it on the chat. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Other questions? Okay. Thank you very much for attending. I will...